Throughout the rest of the 80s and even 90s, Toei Animation created a total of 10 Dr. Slump movies, and they were usually theatrically paired with the corresponding Dragon Ball Z movie at the time. That trend begun with Dr. Slump Movie 6 in 1993, which was released with Broly, the Legendary Super Saiyan. In the following months, a seventh Dr. Slump movie came out with BoJack Unbound, titled Dr. Slump and Arale-chan, Net Chuff from Penguin Village with Love. During the film's runtime, several Dragon Ball Z crossover references can be located. The first of these appearances is very early on in the film, where Snow, her mother, and the village chief from the Muscle Tower sequence in Dragon Ball can be seen in the first act of the movie. A lot of the time, small cameos like this example are extremely common in Toriyama's manga works, especially Dr. Slump here. Merely a few moments later, there includes a brief shot of various Dragon Ball and even characters from Toriyama's manga Pink included. As seen in the image, the Dragon Ball characters consist of Mai, Shu, Pilaf, Lunch, and Oolong. A little later on in the same sequence, there's a shot of a fighter that actually appeared in the BoJack Unbound movie during the tournament at the beginning of the film. Furthermore, in the Arale and helicopter scene, Cell, Vegeta, and even Gohan dolls can be noticed sitting on the dashboard. I can't help but compare these dolls to the Cell Games movie costumes in Dragon Ball Z, but I digress. The next crossover appearance in Dr. Slump Movie 7 is towards the third act, and is a quick visual gag with Yajirobe and Karin running out of the way from the princess's laughter. Now, probably the best cameo is saved towards the climax, like the Yajirobe and Karin one, but it has Goku and Bojack fighting for mere seconds before they vanish. This is great and is very fitting since, as aforementioned, BoJack Unbound was released side by side with Dr. Slump Movie 7. In the subsequent film, Dr. Slump Movie 8, this time called Ho-Yo-Yo, followed the rescue shark, the gag character Superman transforms into a Super Saiyan. Yeah, I surprisingly enjoyed this a lot as I find it to be an intriguing reflection of how particular Western Dragon Ball Z fans view Goku as a Superman clone, so this parody is well played on Toei's part. By the way, the Goku vs. Superman debacle has been evident in crossovers throughout the ages, particularly in the 2000s, as the most prominent being Screwattack's Death Battle and Wizard Magazine's 2002's East vs. West article about the whole debate. The final reference to Dragon Ball in a Dr. Slump film comes in the form of Movie 9, where Shenron can be seen as a water fountain of sorts. You see, the joke here is that this is what Shenron does in his downtime when he's not focusing on that silly Dragon Ball show. Along with the Dr. Slumper movies all through the 90s, there was concurrently a successor manga to the original 1984 Dr. Slump. It was written by Takao Koyama, famous for being the screenwriter for all 13 initial Dragon Ball Z films. The art was drawn by Katsuyoshi Nakasuru, and the story of this manga was approved by Toriyama himself. The manga was named Dr. Slump is Returning, for a little while, or just simply the brief return of Dr. Slump. And during Chapter 11, there's a full-blown parody crossover of Dragon Ball inside. Across the entire serialization of this sequel from 1993 to 1996, the writers made direct parodies to Dragon Quest, Star Wars, pop culture in general, and of course, Dragon Ball. As I was saying, in Chapter 11, there's a direct mock version of Bulma's family, capsules prevalent, many Dr. Slump characters dressing up as Dragon Ball characters, iconic Dragon Ball manga cover spoofs, hell in the anime filler, and of course, in Dr. Slump and Dragon Ball crossover tradition, it seems, a pseudo-Super Saiyan transformation. It's just one huge chapter filled with all of these references, and wow, they went far with this one, ramping up the absurdity in each page in true Dr. Slump fashion. Again, most of the chapters from A Brief Return of Dr. Slump jokes around with a lot of other material also, but speaking of which, let's move on to the 1997 Dr. Slump anime. Yes, after the Dr. Slump anime and sequel manga concluded, Toei went on to produce a 74-episode remake of the original anime in 1997, fittingly named Dr. Slump. Before we get to the Dragon Ball crossovers, in my personal opinion, this 90s Dr. Slump series was kind of an afterthought for Toei Animation, as they were forced to put Dragon Ball GT on cancellation and needed something else to put on the air. Once Dr. Slump 97 concluded its run, One Piece started, and that became a smash hit in Japan. Anyway, that includes a lot of Dragon Ball crossovers over over the course of this remake's run, probably because there wasn't any in the original Dr. Slump anime because they were stuck to the source, the manga of Dr. Slump by Akira Toriyama. And as we know already, Dragon Ball wasn't written until 1984, after Dr. Slump's manga ended, so that's why. Arale dresses up as the Black Star Dragon Ball's version of Shenron from Dragon Ball GT during the episode, which is a massive throwback to her appearing as a raccoon in the chapter variant of the original manga. To the majority of the fanbase in Dragon Ball, one of the main issues with GT is the Black Star Bulls, therefore it's humorous to see the show make the dragon seem ridiculous when worn by Arale. Six episodes later, there's a scene of Arale and her friend Akane fighting on a Dragon Ball Z video game, which in my opinion could be considered foreshadowing to where Arale fights like a Dragon Ball Z character in episode 28 of the remake. She even powers up and performs a beam struggle with another person during episode 28. Anyway, we've seen Dragon Ball references in Dr. Slump 97 so far, but in episodes 55 to 57 is where Goku and the Red Ribbon Army actually show up. These few episodes are kind of parallel with the Dr. Slump crossover in Dragon Ball's Red Ribbon arc, but with characters such as Murasaki added. Oh, and obviously the roles are reversed as well, with Arale as the leader and Goku being the outsider, both in and out of universe. So after Goku lands in Penguin Village, he accidentally looks at the moon and becomes a great ape, but Arale just swings him around and gets him out of it. The Red Ribbon Army are again looking for the Dragon Balls, of course, and almost manage to get their wish even, but ultimately Arale and Goku triumph and defeat them. And this marks the final time for about 18 years that Slumper and Dragon Ball would have an official Toei crossover.